Energy Secretary Jericho Petilla denies he resigned because he didn't favor possible appointments in the Energy Regulatory Commission. But he still has an opinion on some of the personnel moves being planned at the DOE. Alvin El Chico with the story.
This is Secretary Petilla's last birthday as Energy Chief. It's also his last day in office based on his irrevocable resignation, which takes effect April 30. But Petilla's departure does not exactly jibe with President Aquino's pronouncement in Malaysia Tuesday that he stays as secretary until Malacanang finds a replacement.
Wala po ako naaalalang pinag-usapan na definite date.
I'm willing to extend, but I need a legal basis for them. Kailangan kasi wala akong instructions.
But no order from Malacanang came out during office hours Wednesday. Petilla's camp says if his irrevocable resignation was accepted, he would no longer be energy chief by Thursday. Petilla says he will recommend that Undersecretary Zenaida Munsada be named officer in charge until Aquino's term ends next year.
Maybe they should include in their shortlist an OIC undersecretary.
In the person of
Yusek Naidi Monsada.
Petilla has also categorically denied his resignation was caused by the appointment of 75-year-old Jerolimo Santa Ana as Commissioner of the Energy Regulatory Commission and Commissioner Aina Asirit's possible appointment as Chairman of the ERC when Zenaida Ducot retires in July. Asirit is the niece of Cabinet Secretary Jose Rene Almendras, but Petilla has some advice for Asirit.
Kung si Aina magiging chairman, that is the prerogative of the president. Pero kung ako naman si Aina, probably I feel a little bit of a burden. Bakit? Kasi kamag-anak ko si Kapsek. So baka sabihin, minumuro-muro.
Petilla says Malacanang must ensure that appointees at the DOE and ERC should not have any personal motive, but only the interest of consumers and industry players. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.